Welcome today. We're going to start with a gathering song that I will sing, but I would love to have you sing with me if you'd like. It is in the red hymnal at number 122, celebrating the nature and how the nature praises God. In our way to thank God this morning, let's gather here for worship. Would you please stand and join me in the call to worship, which is found here in your bulletin. I will read the light print, and you're invited to read the dark print. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with singing and dancing.
Praise him with the pure heart of the child.
Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Please join in singing Majesty, 176 in the red hymnal. As a way of passing the peace this morning, would you please turn to your neighbors and those across the congregation and give a great wave of joy and peace.
You may be seated. I'm Pastor Don, and I welcome you to worship at the United Methodist Church of Whitefish Bay, and especially the families and friends of our cast members of the children's choir who sing with the praise team and the chancel choir. They're offering this dramatic retelling of the story of Noah's Ark. Now, whether you're worshiping here in the sanctuary a block from beautiful Lake Michigan or live streaming at home or on YouTube or Facebook, please indicate your presence and offer your comments about the service or the production. We have a prayer team that prays for the community and its people. So if you have a request for our prayer team, or would like to know about the church or its local missions, you can send that to prayer@umcwfb.org. prayer@umcwfb.org. We have we love children in the sanctuary. We love children in the sanctuary. We're not bothered by noises of children make, but if you wish, there is a nursery, and the ushers can direct you to the nursery. Pat will now lead us in prayer.
Please join me in a moment of silent and listening prayer. Creator God, we pray for all people in the world who are in need of water, food, shelter, and hope. We pray that you may guide us to help give unceasingly to people in need. Lord of all creation, help us to look after your wonderfully made world. Thank you for allowing us to benefit from the beauty of all that your hand has created. We discover some new beauty every day in God's creation, the sunrise and sunset, birds, flowers, trees, rainbows in the sky, the stars, and the many forms of life in the forest, and the animals of every kind. We listen to the music of the universe, water flowing over rocks, the waves crushing on the shore, the birds singing, the trees swaying in the wind, raindrops pattering our roofs, and children's voices filled with joy. We always remember that God speaks to us through the beauty of his creation, and we will try our best to answer God's call to reverence all that he has majestically created. We will sing to you as long as we live. We will praise you until our last breath. We will not fail to give you glory for the beauty of all that you have created. It is our honor and privilege to care for all the creatures of the earth, and we will respect and value all that your hand has made. The whole earth is filled with your glory. Amen. Please join me now in the prayer our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be.
Thank you, Pat, for that beautiful prayer. Good morning. I'm Jenny Fisher, one of the board members of this church, and I want to thank everyone who has a part in this dramatic retelling of Noah's Ark. The children's choir, the chancel choir, our praise team, the set builders, Neil Bubke, director of our church music program, the assistant directors, parents, church staff, and others. When my husband Matt and I moved from Minneapolis to Whitefish Bay with our first baby 12 years ago, we looked for a church that could provide our family, and especially our children, with an children's ministry program similar to the church that I grew up in that helped me strengthen my faith, serve my community, and build relationships with Christian friends throughout my childhood years. When our oldest daughter, Addie, was enrolled here in Tree of Life Preschool 8 years ago, we received an invitation from her teachers to attend a children's musical performance at this church. What a gift! We sat in the balcony, awestruck and impressed by this congregation's family engagement and enthusiasm. This was especially reflected in the children's ministry program here. That performance inspired our family to begin regularly attending worship, baptize our children, participate in spiritual programming, and become active members of this church. We also support this church financially. If you are a member or a regular attender of our church, thank you for the financial support you have provided. As a member of our stewardship team, I hope you will prayerfully consider pledging your financial support for this church and all of our ministries. Giving to the church is vital to our faith development and an investment in the quality of life in our community. If you are not a regular attender of our church, I hope you will consider becoming an active member of our community of faith and participating in the incredible opportunities for kids of all ages from baptism through confirmation and the worship, mission, ministry, and spiritual growth and fellowship opportunities for adults. The experiences that you will be providing to your families will have a lasting impact on their faith and on their life perspectives. Two decisions that you can make today are to ask a member of our church about one of the programs that you see noted in the flyer that might meet the needs of your family's spiritual growth, and secondly, to consider making a financial donation in support of this musical and other similar programs at our church. Thanks again to the children's choir who made Noah's Ark possible for our experience today, and to those who have been a part or supported this church to carry on the witness of God's promise of grace, hope, and love for all. Thank you.
Thank you, Jenny. Let me read for us our scripture for today. From Jeremiah 17, verses 7 and 8. Happy are those who trust in the Lord, who rely on the Lord. They will be like trees planted by streams whose roots reach down to the water. They won't fear drought when it comes. Their leaves will remain green. They won't be stressed in the time of drought or fail to bear fruit. And from Isaiah 43, verse 2. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. When through the rivers, they won't sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you won't be scorched, and the flame won't burn you. This is the reading of the scripture for today. And now I think our cast is ready to tell us the story of Noah.
Production of Noah's Ark. We hope you enjoy the show.
A long, long time ago, God looked over the face of the earth and saw that humans were screwing up.
Everywhere was disease, death, and destruction. All of the things that God hates the most. In Genesis, the Bible says, people's hearts and minds had turned evil.
Which is another way of saying,
people were acting nasty.
Hold it. I'm sorry, but you were enjoying that way too much.
Aww. All this chaos was making the earth itself a pretty rotten place.
So God decided to wipe everything off the face of earth and start over.
Whoa.
Now the one bright spot in this picture was a couple by the name of Mr. and Mrs. Noah.
So God spoke to Noah and asked him to build a great big boat
called an ark
out of gopher wood,
which is another name of hickory, and not a description of how he had to get it.
go for wood, go for the wood.
Sorry, folks, the jokes don't get any better. It's going to storm soon.
I heard it's going to rain cats and dogs.
If it rains cats and dogs, we better be careful.
Yeah, we might step in a poodle.
Oh, our handsome. Oh, our husband. Handsome.
Humorous.
And handy.
How can we help you, fellas?
Can you go fetch some more wood?
Sure, Dad, but geez, how much more do we need?
God says to build it 300 cubits long,
50 cubits wide,
and 30 cubits tall.
Nolan?
What's all?
This kibitzing? You just interrupted my first nap in the morning.
His name is Noah, Mom.
That's what I said, Norman. Now, what's all this? Kibitzing?
Cubits, Grandma. Cubits.
It's how we measure things for our boat.
What's this all? A boat?
We're building a boat.
To weather the storm.
That will wash away all the violence happening in our world.
Don't worry, Edna. God told me to make plenty of room for all the animals I can find. The mother-in-law suite will be right next to the honey badgers and the Central African pythons. I think you'll feel right at home.
Yes, Nolan. Mark off my room with the pylons. That'll keep the riffraff out of my part of your raft. I'm heading back inside for my 10:30 nap. Could you keep something less than a fever pitch out here? Edna, out.
Pitch, we need pitch.
Yes, we need pitch to paint on the planks to prevent permeability post-precipitation.
Precisely.
Noah and his family went right to work.
They took care of business. Till it starts raining.
Let me get this straight. You think it's gonna rain so hard that this great big homemade thing here is gonna float?
That's what God said.
Oh, your God told you. Well, that's different then.
These people have lost their marbles.
They're brave.
I'd say they're
Noah clue. Get it? Noah clue?
That's amazing. An entire family tree that produces nuts?
And with that, the neighbors really began to make fun of Noah.
Hey there, Noah, what kind of feather grain fills a boat but doesn't check the weather vane? There's no cloud in a big blue sky. I think your god's up too high and dry.
You may think we're some kind of oddities, call us nuts, but we're as merry as
from her second nap of the morning.
Oh. She and the others gathered around the ark.
They kneeled and prayed to the Lord.
After the prayer, Noah and his family worshiped their God and saw.
I've been wandering to the desert. It's been a cloud in forever.
Grandma, did you forget to take your Pepcide? Pepcide.
Yes, I drank 3 Pepsis for breakfast this morning. I've never felt so energized.
God's promise is coming true. It's a storm.
T-shirt and pants.
Don't forget
let's go out and collect all the animals.
Collecting all the critters, two of every kind that they can find, I'm going to invite the ushers to come forward to collect our morning tithes and offerings. The drama that you see is paid for from our operating fund, so please give generously with a happy heart.
Thank you. just like that cheerful chickadee. Listen while you work. Come on, get smart. Tune up and start to whistle while you work. Like the cheerful chickadee, and whistle while you work. Come on, get smart, tune up, and start to whistle while you work.
After 10 days, or shall we say 10 minutes, Noah and his wife returned home, but this time their family was much, much bigger.
hummingbirds, cuckoo.
Porpoise, pandas, chimpanzees, woodchucks wiggling on their knees.
Wallabies waltzing the narwhals rock, turtles twisting around the clock.
Flamingo flop and the buffalo bop,
all together let's sing from the top.
When they got on the ark.
His sons and their wives were responsible for feeding all of us animals.
They brought plenty of leaves and corn for the elephants and rabbits. They told the cows to give milk for the cats.
And they made sure the cats wouldn't eat the mice.
Noah told the bees to make honey for the bears.
Shem, Ham, and Japhet were in charge of keeping the animals clean.
They had to sweep up the stables and wash the cages.
They even had to save the poo for fertilizer.
Now, most people know about the 40 days and 40 nights of rain.
But what you may not know is that was just the beginning.
The Bible says the waters covered the earth for 150 days. Yeah, things got really tough.
Turtles refused to come out of their shells. The bloodhounds were sneezing because of the smells.
The lovebirds were fighting, the doves were at war. A sow was complaining, his mate was a boar. A porcupine mister got hurt by his miss. Was getting over eager, attempting a kiss.
Such an ordeal, a crocodile shed a few tears that were real.
We shed all of our neighbors, so I think it's rude how the lions were eyeing their neighbors as food. An antelope found what he thought was a house and got sick when he drank from an elephant's nose.
Shellfish were shellfish, the clam couldn't talk, the slugs didn't pick up the Sunday Walker.
The black widow's finer, just what she said. She hadn't seen her husband since breakfast in bed.
The boa constrictors got aches in their backs. The canvas termites were showing some cracks.
A spotted giraffe had a pain in her throat. A nearsighted whale fell in love with a buck.
When Adam follows you day after day, the word of the Lord can be hard to obey.
wind blow over the earth and the waters subsided.
The fountains of the deep and the windows of the heavens were closed.
And the ark came to rest upon the mountains of Ararat.
And Noah opened the window to the ark and sent forth the dove.
The dove returned with an olive branch.
So Noah knew the waters had subsided.
Then Noah waited another 7 days and sent forth both the doves.
Neither of them returned this time.
The rain had stopped.
The boat came to rest on land.
And God
signed a peace, sign of joy, sign of love.
And God said to Noah, I am establishing my covenant with you and every living creature that is with you,
that never again shall there be a flood to destroy the whole earth again.
Yeah!
God said, this is the sign of the covenant I make between me and you and every living creature for all future generations.
I have set my rainbow in the clouds, and it shall be a sign of the covenant between me and the earth.
Noah's family and the animals were able to safely exit the ark, enjoy the renewed land, and live in the hope and promise of the new life God had provided.
Even Edna found joy and contentment after all.
Yeah.
Yeah.
time I go for the Bible, gotta hold myself down. Cause I just can't wait till it wakes that your love is abound. I'm walking on sunshine, whoa. I'm walking on sunshine, whoa. I'm walking on sunshine, whoa. And don't it feel good?
Oh, you guys are great. Noah, I've got a question for you. God sent the flood. What did he ask you to do?
To build an ark.
Yeah, why did it have to be so big?
So I could fit all the animals in.
All the animals. Oh, okay, okay. Well, and then, and you did that despite the criticism of the neighbors.
Yeah.
Okay. After the flood, what promise did God make to Noah and all the people? Now, I think I should ask Rosalind. Where is Rosalind? There's the skunk. Yeah. What promise did God make to all the people?
The rainbow?
Okay, and what did the rainbow signify? What was a sign of?
That he wouldn't flood the whole entire earth again, and he promised to not do what he did again.
And God kept his promise, didn't he? We haven't seen a flood of over all the world since then. Well, thank you for telling us the story. Now, here's my point. I think these days, we are all Noah and his family. What that means for me is that, okay, God kept his promise. Now we have to keep our promise. And what did Noah promise to do? Build the ark and collect all the critters. So Noah was taking care of the creation. And I think that's our job today. We are all Noah and his family, taking care of creation. And most of you are critters. Well, take care of your critter. Take care of your critter. All right. This is Rosalind Skunk. This is what the Bible says, that you told us what it says. This is the symbol of the covenant that I am drawing up between me and you and every living thing with you. On behalf of every future generation, I have placed my rainbow in the clouds. It will be a symbol of the covenant between me and the earth. And that's from Genesis 9, verses 12 and 13. Well, I want to thank you for bringing the story back to us in such a wonderful way, such a lively way. Now, I want to invite us all to, after worship, to think to spaghetti dinner downstairs. It's going to be a fundraiser for the youth mission trip this summer to Appalachia Service Project. Now, shall we sing?
Oh, you've got to. Thank you, Pastor Don. Before we wrap up our service today, I just want to thank some people who made today possible. First of all, let's give it up for the people who put in a full day's work on establishing this rainbow, John and Carol Cuxhaus. And in order to see the rainbow, we had to have an expert lighting technician for our shows today who came to the dress rehearsals as well, way back up in the sound booth or the light booth, Samantha Gundrow. As you can see in our program, we've got a pretty amazing group of parent volunteers for our children's choir program at the United Methodist Church, Whitefish Bay. Let's give it up for Dan and Chelsea Montague, Matt Annan, Nina Melia, Tabitha Stege, Jody Belke, and Jenny Fisher. We also want to thank the people who were the masterminds behind this beautiful, beautiful set. And those two people have been longtime, more than 20-year members of the congregation. That's John and Karen Wellstead. John's back in the sound booth right now. And Karen Wellstead. Incidentally, Karen and John aren't just good at huge set artwork, but they're fine artists in other ways as well. And Karen will actually be having her own artwork on display in the church's open door gallery. So you can see some of her photography, oil paintings, and maybe a few watercolors as well. And that's gonna be installed the first week of May. I also wanna thank our live stream person, Mary Paul, who makes it possible not only for the people at home to watch the show, but for the kids to go back and watch it on YouTube. Mary Paul in the sound booth. There's only one way to grow a church, and that is to show up and be in life with each other. All of the parents and honorary aunts and uncles and grandmas who helped with costumes and set building and makeup, please stand. All you parents should really stand. I think you all helped with this. Yeah. Fantastic work. I think we've got it covered. Sorry, Skunk.
Well, of course, we can't conclude this wonderful production without thanking the brains and energy behind the whole production.
You guys!
Neil Bubke, the director of our church music program. We're so grateful for
Thank
Neil and
much.
Everything he does.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Hello?
So let's stand and sing out of the hymnal 374, Standing on God's Promises Forever and Ever. Standing on the promises of Christ my King, through eternal ages let his praises ring. It's coming. Glory in the highest, I will shout and sing. Here it is.
Standing on the promises of God, standing on the promises of God,
my Savior,
standing,
I'm standing
on the promises of God,
standing on the promises of God,
when the howling storms of life appear assail, by the living word of God I shall prevail.
Standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises of God, our Savior.
Standing.
I'm standing on the promises of God.
Standing on the promises of Christ, my King. Eternally by love's strong cord, overcoming daily by the Spirit's sword,
standing on the promises of God.
We have been blessed by this story again, and now I send you with a blessing of God's love, Christ's grace, and the bonding fellowship creates community among us, the Holy Spirit. Amen.